Awesome in this place. He is awesome this morning. Hallelujah. Just open up your mouth for just a few seconds and just say, God, I thank you. God, I thank you this morning. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for your many blessings that you have bestowed upon me. I thank you, Lord. I thank you this morning. You're so awesome. You're so awesome. You're so magnificent, Lord. And I give you all the praise and all the glory and all of the honor simply because you woke me up this morning and you placed me in my right mind. So I thank you, Lord. I'm thanking you, Lord, because I'm above ground this morning. And so I shabak and I toda you because you're an amazing God. You're faithful. And we honor you this morning. Welcome one and all to Recharge Ministries. This is a day that the Lord has made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. So I give God, I give Yahweh, the I am that I am, all the praise and all the glory. So welcome one and all on Zoom, on Facebook, all the digital platforms that you're connecting in on this morning. I welcome you to Recharge Ministries. And we're going to go right into the word. A continuation of the word from last week said, Jesus is calling your name. The commands are clear. And this is part two. The commands are clear. Jesus is calling your name, and the commands are clear. Father, this morning, I just want to thank you, Lord. I want to thank you for your presence. I want to thank you for your indwelling power this morning. I thank you, Lord God, for the rhema word that came from on high. And Lord, I pray that as your word is poured out this morning, your people will receive, hallelujah, and they will say that it is a blessing for them to have heard your word and for them to be in your presence this morning. Father, have your way. As I decrease and you increase, Lord, let your word germinate. Let your word be poured out upon your people this morning. And we give you all the praise and all the glory and all of the honor. And we say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost, amen and amen. So, like I said last week, we spoke on Jesus is calling your name and the commands are clear. And we spoke about and we covered two commands from last week. And so this week I will do a refresh of the two that we did last week. And then I will go right into the remaining three. And it's taken from 1 Corinthians 16, 13 to 14, reading from the English Standard Version. Be watchful. Stand firm in the faith. Act like men. Be strong and let all that you do be done in love. So these are five laser focus commands stated in 1 Corinthians 16, 13 to 14. Be watchful. Stand firm in the faith. Act like men, meaning be courageous in some other versions. Be strong and let all that you do be done in love. So, as a reminder this morning, these five commands came about to bring the dysfunctional and messed up Corinthians church into order. As Paul the Apostle speaking under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, he addresses these problems and he gives these five sharp, clear commands. Be watchful, stand firm in the faith, act like men, be strong, and let all you do be done in love. So these five clear commands to God's people are transcultural. It lasts through every generation. So it's not just for the Corinthians church, but it's transcultural and it lasts through every generation all over the world, bringing order out of chaos. Bringing order out of chaos. So, as a summary from the first command, being watchful, this is a call to be vigilant in the Christian life. So the question is asked, so what are we supposed to watch for? Watch for Satan and his demonic cohorts and his devices. First Peter 5, verse 8 says, be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion seeking someone to devour. And that someone is you. So Paul says we ought to be aware. Not unaware, but aware of Satan's schemes. And he says in 1 Corinthians 2, verse 11, in order that Satan might not outwit us. For we are not unaware of his schemes. We should never be caught off guard. We should always be on the watch. We should always be aware. We need to be aware of all of Satan's tactics. So watch in reference to Satan and his demonic forces. And Jesus said to his disciples, we watch and pray. In Matthew 26, verse 41, he says, watch and pray. So that you'll not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak. I think that that's one of our famous sayings. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak. So if you are not prayed up, you're not watching and praying. If you're not prayed up, your spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. We are to watch and pray. And Paul says to Timothy in 1 Timothy 4, verse 16, watch your life and your doctrine closely. Persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourselves and your ears, the ones that are listening to you. Watch your lifestyle. What habits are you in? What are your patterns? Watch it. Watch it closely. Jesus says very plainly in Mark 13, he said, be on guard, be alert. You do not know when that time will come. And that time is when our Lord Jesus Christ will put in his appearance. It's like a man going away and he leaves his house and put his servants in order, each with his assigned task. And he tells the one at the door to watch, keep, to keep watch. And therefore keep watch, because you do not know when the owner of the house will come back. And the owner of the house is our Lord Jesus Christ. He's coming back again. And we don't know whether it's in the evening or at midnight, or when the roosters crow or at dawn. And if he comes suddenly, do not let him find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to everyone, watch and be ready. Watch and be ready. Be ready, not getting ready, but be ready. Watch and be ready. The second command was stand firm in the faith. The second command is the faith is. It's doctrine. It's not just stand firm in your faith or in faith, but stand firm in the faith, in these sets of doctrines, these sets of teachings that comes from the scripture, from the Holy Spirit, through the Bible. Stand firm on doctrine, because we need to be stable and resolute. We need to be unshakable and unmovable, because Satan is throwing wave after wave of attacks on our doctrinal life, let alone on us. New concepts are coming about that's challenging our doctrinal beliefs. Your Christianity, your understanding of the doctrine, these new age concepts are coming fast and furious. So the Lord is imploring us, be strong in the word. Read the word daily. Actually, right now, rechargers are going through the Bible. We're reading the word of God daily. And I tell you, the passions are coming alive. Every day when we get on at 6:30 in the morning, everybody got their scriptures and their readings out, because we're reading the word daily. You need to drink the word every day. Just like how you pick up a bottle of water or a glass of water, you gotta drink the word daily. Feed your soul in the word of God. Meditate on the word of God. Hide the word in your heart and study to show thyself approved. Stand firm in the faith. If you're not reading, how can you stand firm in the faith? If you're not meditating on the word of God, then how can you stand firm in the faith? When the New Age Christians come upon you, what are you going to do? And when they back you up, because every day they're in a room, they're in a setting where they're beating the word just to come out to trip you up. And if you're not reading the word, then what are you going to do? What's your answer? So you must stand firm in the faith. So we're caught up now. Part two. And the third is act like men or be courageous. Act like men or be courageous. So remember, the scripture says, be watchful, stand firm in the faith, act like men or be courageous, be strong, and let all that you do be done in love. So the third command is act like men or be courageous. So the phrase be courageous in this context is an exhortation for believers to be strong and brave in their faith and their conduct. And the specific phrase, which means act like men, is translated from the Greek word andresame. Andresame, and it means quit like men. That's a famous statement that's used. Quit like men, which is used just like what? Which is used one time in the Bible, act like men. It is an imperative, a word of command, and it literally means be men, be courageous, or be strong. It calls for believers to embody strength, bravery, and resilience in their Christian journey, trusting in God's guidance and acting in accordance with the principles of love and faith. He's imploring us as believers to embody bravery and don't act like children. In essence, grow up. Grow up. It's time to stop drinking milk and eat the substance that will enhance your Christian growth. Grow up. Too many of us in Christendom are at children's stage. Children like behaviors. This is imploring us to grow up. And Paul openly says in chapter 14, they are acting like children. And he tells them they are to stop acting like children. I tell you that God is intentional. And he uses the same Greek word in 1 Corinthians 13 and 11 when he says, when I was a child, I thought like a child. I talked like a child. I reasoned like a child. And when I became a man, I put away childish ways behind me. So it's the same thing. When I become a man in the essence of both man and woman, as opposed to a child, I must grow up and be mature. When we were children, excluding the children on the line, when we were children, we act like children. We played in the front yard or wherever it was. We had no cares of the world. As we matured and we became adults, we became different people because we had sets of responsibilities that we couldn't ignore. This is saying the same thing. Grow up and be mature in the faith. Be mature in your thinking, in your understanding, in your wisdom, in your walk. We must take up the shield of faith. We have to take up the sword of the spirit, and we have to fight because we have spiritual battles that are beating us left, right, and center every day. And we gotta fight. to ward off the enemy, and to remain strong and resilient in the battle. God is commanding all of us to show that level of courage, because we are to fight this good old gospel fight. We gotta show courage. Show up with bravery, even when no one else around you are being brave. Show up and show out, because every day our God is showing up and showing out. The next command following this one is be strengthened. This is not something that we generate in word and of ourselves, but it's something that we are commanded to receive from God. I want to say that again. This is not something that we generate in of ourselves, but it's something that we are commanded to receive from God. And God says, receive his strengthening. Receive his strength. Fundamental to this is a need for ongoing strength in the Christian life. Why? Because life saps us daily. That's why the word of God says his mercies are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Because life saps us daily. It saps our strength. It drains us. And we feel less than strong at the end of the day because of what the day does to us. Physically, spiritually, emotionally, financially. We feel weary because of the issues of life. The sorrows of this life, the affliction, the disease, the disappointment, the pain, the emotion, the struggles. It saps our strength and it drains us dry. And so we need ongoing strength from Abba to replenish, to refuel, and to recharge us. Now, how do I know that this is true? Because I tell you, reading is fundamental to me these days. I want to uncover. I want to dive into the word. I want to know what the word says. And Isaiah 40 verse 30 to 31 says, even youth grow tired and stumble, and young men stumble and fall. But those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. That's the idea as to why we need ongoing strength from Abba to replenish, refuel, and recharge us. Because we need to go into him when we grow tired. And we stumble, the Lord says, he will renew your strength. That you will run and not grow weary. That you will walk and not grow faint. Psalm 23 verse 2 says, the Lord makes us lie down in green pastures, and he leads us beside quiet waters, meaning that he restores my soul. Hallelujah. When my soul is drained, he restores my soul. He restores my soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So get quiet before the Lord and meditate on his strengthening promises. Get in his presence in prayer and get your spiritual battery recharged. Hallelujah. Just like how you have your smartphone. This is my famous example because all of us are glued to this phone. But if you're glued to it 24/7, it needs to be charged. And that's what the Lord is saying. When it comes to our spiritual life, get into the presence of God. Get into this presence with prayer. Hallelujah. And he will charge up your battery spiritually, because the world saps you. Ephesians 6 verse 10 says, be strong in the Lord and in his power and might. In his mighty power. And part of that strengthening is recognizing your Weakness. Uh-oh. Be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. That's what Ephesians 6 verse 10 says. And part of that strengthening is recognizing your weakness. Every day, I do introspection to recognize where I came short today. Do I always get it right? No. But every day I'm intentional about that reflection. Every day I pause in my day and say, Lord, what could I have done differently today? I know I didn't do this part right. I know this part I stumbled and I fell. But Lord, I know because of you, I was able to recover. It's recognizing your weakness. Where are you coming short? Because God is saying, when you know where you come short, you can be strengthened in him. And Paul says, when I am weak, then I am strong. Like I said, I said, okay, God, that's not a complete statement. It's very fragmented. When I am weak, then I'm strong. But it's not complete. So I said, God, I think what Paul meant was, when I am weak, I am strong when I take it to the Lord in prayer. And I know that to be true, because when I am weak and I go to God in prayer, I am strengthened. I'm renewed. When I crawl into Daddy, I say, Abba, Father, today, oh, I'm not at my best. Just can't do this, Lord. Oh, he loves on me like a dad does to a daughter. And he poured strength into me. So that's what I think Paul meant was, when I am weak, I am strong when I take it to the Lord in prayer. When I go into Daddy and I lay before him and I said, Daddy, oh, I just can't do this on my own. When I realize I can't do this, God, I'm coming and I'm running into your arms. And then I said, would you please strengthen me? And then I will be strengthened because Daddy pours out upon us. Be strengthened today because Daddy's arms are always wide open. He's your comfort and he's your guide. He's your source. He's your all in all. He will never turn his back on you. If you knock, if you run into him, the doors are open to you. So when you don't know what to do, run into Daddy's arms. Run into Daddy's arms for your plans, your thoughts. Everything concerning you, give it to Daddy. Because he wants all of you. And that's when you're broken. He wants you when you're thinking and you're processing. Just run into his arms and be strengthened and be renewed and be revived and be restored and be recharged and be replenished. And all of the re is that you had it before and you need another dose of it again. So run into his arms and be strengthened and be renewed. The fifth command is do everything in love. So the final of all of these commands sums up everything. And it literally says, let all your things be done. Be done in love. Everything you do, be in love. And 1 Corinthians 13, 1 to 2 says, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clinging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. What does all of that mean? Paul is demonstrating just how worthless the spiritual gifts are when attempted without love for others. The Corinthians valued these gifts highly and elevated those among them with the gift of tongues and prophecy as the most spiritual. But Paul says the gifts are meaningless when practiced without love. Even more, the loveless person that's playing the gift, it's nothing. By this, Paul means the person is accomplishing nothing within the body of Christ. The gift is being wasted on him or her in that moment if that person does not have love. And Paul says, this is true even of the gifts of the prophecy and prophetic powers, which he described as one of the most higher gifts in the previous chapter in 1 Corinthians 12, 28 and 31. He puts that gift together with the gift of the of our knowledge and the gift of faith. So imagine a person, Paul writes, with the gift of prophecy and a full understanding of all the mysteries of God. An ironclad faith that allowed him to move actual mountains. Even this imagery, Paul and Paul describes, without love is nothing. So you could do all of that, be on points. But if you have not love, you have nothing. All those gifts become worthless because you have no love. 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8 says, love is patient. Love is kind. It doesn't envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Every time I read this particular verse, I'm checked. Love never fails. So just take these verses and apply them to your spirit. Apply them to your heart. Let it wash your heart. Pray them in your marriage. To strengthen your marriage. Pray them in your relationships and your friendships. Because you see, your husband or your wife might not do everything right. What did the word say? It keeps no record of wrongs. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. No, love never fails. Pray them in your relationships and your friendships. Your friend might not do everything right. God never fails. Pray them in your heart. Say, Lord, I want to be patient. I want to be kind. I want to be humble. I want to be selfless. More of you, God, and less of me. So just let everything that you do be characterized by these words. Let all the things that you do be done in love. And when you fall, it's not weakness to say, I'm sorry. It's not a weakness to say, I'm sorry. It's actually you are strong in that moment because you have the courage to say, I'm sorry. Love is the capstone. That's the finishing touch on all of this. And based on what I read, and I think if you did all these other commands, if you didn't have love, it would be worthless. That's why Paul ended it with love. If you are watchful, if you stand in the faith, if you acted like men, meaning you are courageous and you are strengthened, if you did all those commands to the T, if you didn't have love, it would be worthless. It will be worthless just because you are vigilant, you stood on faith, you are bold and courageous like a warrior, like I know that God knows that you can. If you are strong and mighty, but if you are unloving, you will do damage to the church. You do damage. If you were doing all of the four before the fifth one, but there is no love, you will do damage to the body of Christ. Because love is the capstone. That's the finishing touch. That is a creme de la creme. Leading with love. Leading with love. Exuding love. Applying love, extending love. That's love. That's love. And love can move a multitude of sin. When you have love, it breaks the back of the enemy. It breaks the back of the enemy. That's why it's the most difficult thing to do. And the enemy prevents us from loving because it breaks the very back of the enemy. Love, that little four-letter word, it breaks the back of the enemy. When you exude love, extend love, it breaks the back of the vilest sinner. It calms a situation. That's volatile when you extend love. So in all that you do, extend love. And in closing, these five straightforward commands are very clear. Be watchful. Stand firm in the faith. In the faith. Act like men. Be courageous. Be strengthened. And do everything in love. The Lord also is saying today, Turn these commands into promises. Turn them around into his promises. Just make them promises versus, oh, I have to do this. But these are the promises of God. This is what you have commanded me to do. Now do it in me, Lord. Lord, this is what you have commanded me to do and be. Now do it in me. Do these things in me, God. Lord, help me to be watchful. God, help me. Help me to not grow weary, Lord. Help me not to lose hope. Help me to be strong and stand firm in your faith, in the faith that you're set before me. Help me to be courageous, to act like the men and women that you've called us to be. Strengthen me, oh God, because the days, Lord, are sapping my very strength, but in you I will find strength. So strengthen me. Lord, it's hard at times to love others, especially when they've hurt, when the hurt is real. When they have deceived me, God. When they have manipulated me, God, it's hard. But teach me how to love and to do everything in love, God. And through love, Lord God, forgiveness is given. Real forgiveness, God. Help me, Lord. So take them up to God in prayer and ask God to fulfill all these things in you and through you. Because these commands are real. How do I persevere? How do I make it through, God? So I turn them back over to you, God. Now do it in me. Perfect it in me. Take it out of me, God. Ah, mold me and shape me into who that you have called me to be, God. All these commands, Lord God, you didn't give it because you know I can't do it. But Lord God, I'm going to need you to do it. Do it in me, God. Do it in me, God. Perfect it through me, God. That's a cry of our heart. That's a prayer that we're sending to God to help us through, to fulfill these commands, which will become promises, which will become the finishing touch on our lives. So are you standing firm in the faith? Are you strong doctrinally? Do you feel yourself flickering? Do you find yourself wavering? Because if you're flickering, just go back and say, there's no doubt what the Bible is saying, and I stand firm in the faith. God is not wavering on this. So why am I? God, make me rock solid in the faith by reading your word regularly, Lord. Let me commit to doing it regularly. Strengthen my soul, God, so I can hear you. What about your boldness? Are you being bold and courageous as a warrior? Are you acting Christ-like daily? Are you fighting courageously? Are you putting on the spiritual armor and fighting for holiness? Are you bold as a lion and a lioness? Are you being strengthened? Or do you feel weak? The Lord wants you to go into this week stronger than you were last week. So be strengthened today through God's word. That's why the importance of reading and meditating on God's word, because it strengthens you. And finally, do everything in love. Do everything in love. Am I patient? Am I kind? Am I patient? Am I kind? Am I loving? Does it exude from me? And for a struggling marriage this morning, those are the two powerful things in marriages that will bring it back together again. Am I patient and kind? Do I keep a record of wrongs? Or I'm constantly whipping out the notebook. On this date, you did this. On this date, you did that. Do I keep a record of wrongs? Am I a bitter person? God is saying this morning, I can give you a tender heart if you allow me to. I can mold you and make you into who you were destined to be and will be. I believe that God draws people in times like these because he's a drawer. John 6 and verse 44 says, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws them. And I will raise them up at the last day. Before you ever come to Christ, there is a drawing. And God is drawing you and I today closer to him. All we need to do is humbly come and say, Lord, here am I. Here am I, Lord. I'm broken, but you can mend me. Here am I, Lord. I've been bruised, misused, but I know you can heal my heart. Lord, I've been beaten down on every side. Life has not been fair to me, God. It's one struggle after another. God is saying, I am your strength. I am your shield and your defense. Come, I will give you rest. Today, God is calling all of us into repentance of everything. And for the sinners that are watching, and even if this morning you're a backslider, he's calling unto you this morning. For those that aren't so strong, he's calling you. He's calling all of us who have come short of the glory. And every day we come short. So none is exempt. All we got to do is repent of our sin. I said, Jesus, I'm a sinner. And you died for sinners. I trust in you. Forgive me. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me. Accept me this morning. And believe me, he will. The angels in heaven are rejoicing this morning. If you just said, Jesus, I'm a sinner. You died for sinners. I trust in you, God. I trust in you. Forgive me. Forgive me of all my sins. And he will welcome you into his rest. Like I said, these commands won't save your soul. It's faith in Christ that saves your soul. These commands are what we must do. And this is the work of God through you. But you must believe in the one he has sent to save us. And if you believe, you will receive forgiveness this morning. This is a new day. This is a new day. He's wiping your slate clean. Allow him to just wipe it clean. Allow him to step into your heart and mold you and make it tender again. Many of you, your hearts have been hardened. Let him tenderize your heart today. Let him pull out the venom and make you over and make you brand new. There is room at the cross for you. Though millions have come, there is still room for one. There is room at the cross for you this morning. There's room for you. Yes, you. I'm talking to you. There is room at the cross. God does the joy, not me. I release this word over you, and he will do the rest. There's room at the cross. He's saying, come, I will give you. Sweet rest. Just come this morning. Lord God, I come before you this morning. Father, thank you for the clarity of these commands. I thank you that we have a commanding officer through the Holy Spirit who gives clear, sharp, understandable commands to us in this Christian journey, in this Christian life. We know we're not saved by obeying these commands. We're saved through you, our Lord Jesus Christ, by our obedience to all your commands. Through your righteousness, Lord, we are saved. Having been saved, justified by faith, we ask, how shall we live? And these commands tell us how to live. So I pray that we will be strengthened each day, one with another, based on these words. Father, I thank you for these words, Lord, that will renew us and recharge us for your glory. Lord, I pray that as it seeps into our spirit, Lord, we will be transformed. Lord God, we will see the transformation of a new life. We will be all that you have called us to be. Lord, the hurts will be wiped away. The doubts will flee. The turmoil will be replaced with peace, because you are peace in the midst of the storm. The foul and angry words will turn to love, because love is patient and love is kind. We'll be steadfast in the faith, because we're meditating and reading your word. Passion will be exuded from us Because we know what your word says concerning us. We'll be watchful and not grow weary. We will be ready when you call our name. So, Father, today, pour in the oil. Wrap us close this morning, Lord. As your children come and surrender before you and fall before you, let them feel your touch and your loving arms around them. Because you are God alone, the faithful one. And so we thank you this morning for your love that never ends and never runs out. And we glorify your name. And we say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost. Amen and amen. Because it is so. I pray that you will receive the word of the Lord today. Be strengthened, be renewed. That your journey and your walk with him will never be the same. Because the Lord has taken your hand and is leading you all the way. God bless you from Pastor Mark and I, Carleen Hepburn. I pray that you will receive his love today and your walk with him will never be the same. God bless you from Recharge Ministries. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, one and all. God bless you. We love you, everybody. This is Recharge Ministries, and we're just so elated to be a part of what God is doing in this season and in this time. We are elated to be a part of the family of God. We are elated to serve him, hallelujah, and to fall at his feet this morning because he is the great I am. And so this morning, I lift him up and I say, Father, I just want to thank you for all that you have done, for all that you continue to do in our lives.